click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, today we will see helium neon laser. We know helium neon laser is a 4-level laser system and it has a huge application. So let us see what is helium neon laser. First of all, we have helium and neon. We know helium and neon are a gases, that's why it is belonging to the category of gas laser. It consists of mixture of helium and neon gases and its proportion is 10:1. 10:1 proportion is given means here we have a 10 times of helium atoms and 1 times of neon atoms. Then, as we know, this is the category of gas laser, so here we are using pumping, that is electrical pumping. But in electrical pumping, we are using, that is excitation by inelastic collision. So we can say here, pumping, here when we are saying excitation by inelastic collision, in that case, we have two type of atoms in the laser system. So here we are considering helium and neon. So highly accelerated electrons will collide on the ground state helium atom. Now, this electron will transfer its energy to the ground state helium atom and the helium atom will jump into the excited state. So, this excited state helium atom now transfer its energy or collide with the ground state neon atom. And it transfer its energy to the neon atom. So, neon atom will jump into the excited state and helium will come back to the ground state. So this type of pumping scheme is called as excitation by inelastic collision. Now here, active medium in this helium neon laser is neon. Active medium is a medium in which laser action takes place. Means because of that atom, we are getting the laser action. In case of helium neon atom, we have helium and neon. But active system here is neon atoms. Means because of neon atom, we are getting laser action. Then what's the role of helium? Helium is only used to excite neon atom from ground state to excited state. Then, helium neon laser system is a 4-level laser system. Let us see the construction of helium neon laser. It consists of a glass tube of length 30 cm and diameter is 1.5 cm. Both the ends of this tube is covered with the mirror. So first mirror is partially reflecting mirror. So partially reflecting, we can say there is a 10% of transmission and 90% of reflection. As there is a 10% of transmission, means we will get laser output from that side. Now we have other mirror, that is fully reflecting mirror or fully polished mirror. There is a 100% of reflection, means laser beam will not come from that side. So we will have only one side where we will get a laser beam. Then, as we know, this is an electrical pumping, so here we are using a strong power supply. Then, here in this cavity, we have a mixture of helium and neon and its proportion is 10:1. Let us see working and energy level diagram for helium neon laser. When we switch on the power supply, electron will acquire energy and it accelerate. This highly accelerated electron will collide on neon and helium gases. But we know neon gases are heavier and helium is lighter. So even if electron collide with the neon, there is no effect. But helium will acquire energy from the electrons and it will excite into the higher energy level. So the excited energy level, that is a metastable state for the helium, is F2 and F3. Let us say F1 is a ground state for the helium atom. Means after acquiring energy from the electron, helium will jump into the excited state F2 and F3. Now this F2 and F3 both are the metastable state for the helium atom. Means helium atom will spend more time there. As there is a property of helium, it cannot come down to the ground state by the emission of energy through spontaneous process or through the stimulated process. It can only transfer its energy to other atom and then come back to the ground state. So here, other atom presents are neon atom. And the status of neon is now our ground state. So this excited state helium will collide on the ground state neon atom. And helium transfer its energy to the neon and come down to the ground state. After taking energy from the helium, neon will jump into the excited state. Excited state of neon, that is E4 and E6. Now, this neon energy level E4 and E6 are equivalent to the helium energy level F2 and F3. So here we have two energy level, that is E6, which is a metastable state for neon atom. E4 is also metastable state for the neon atom. So after transferring its energy, this helium atom will come back to the ground state and neon atom will jump into the E4 and E6 energy level. As we know, for laser action, two things are very important. First one is a metastable state. So here, E6 and E4, both are the metastable state. And second condition is a population inversion. Now, population inversion means here, the number of particle in the upper energy level should be more than the particle in the lower energy level. So here, we consider this is energy level E5, E4. We'll say this is E3. E2 and ground state of neon is E1. There are more number of particle in E6 and E5 is virtually empty. Means population inversion will achieve in between E6 and E5. And here we will get a stimulated emission. So we'll say the transition from E6 to E5 is a stimulated emission. And we know stimulated emission is nothing but laser. So here we have wavelength of laser, that is 3.39 micrometer. This is in the IR region. Now, second possibility is here. E6 is again metastable state. E3 is only excited state. Means E3 is virtually empty. So, there is a population inversion achieved in between E6 and E3 also. Hence, we have a next transition, that is from E6 to E3. Again, here we will get a laser action, that is a stimulated emission. And here we have value, that is 6328 angstrom unit. And this is the visible region. It is red color laser beam. So we'll say this is the visible region. Now, E6 to E4 transition is not possible because both are the metastable state. So in that case, the population inversion is difficult. So if there is a transition from E6 to E4, there is no laser action takes place. Now, we have third transition, that is from E4 to E3. Again, we are saying E3 is virtually empty, E4 is a metastable state. So here, we have a laser action, means stimulated emission. Laser beam will come out with wavelength 1.15 micrometer, again in the IR region. Now, here E3 is only excited state, means lifetime of the particle in excited state is very less. So, spontaneously, this particle will come back to energy level E2. As this is only excited state, so here we have an emission that is a spontaneous emission. Now, in this case, E2 is again a metastable state. The energy level E2 of neon is a metastable state, but we know population inversion is quite difficult in this case because here we have to achieve population inversion between ground state and the excited state. But here ground state is always a populated state because it is a most stable state. So population inversion is not possible in between E1 and E2. That's why even if it is a metastable state, it will not give us a laser action, that is a stimulated emission. Hence, we can say there is a spontaneous emission or we can say there is a de-excitation of the particle. In this way, entire process can take place in case of the helium neon laser. So here we have laser action. The first transition is E6 to E5. Now, here we have first transition is E6 to E5. It emits 3.39 micrometer wavelength, which is in the IR region. This is again a laser action. Second one we have, that is E6 to E3. It emits E6 to E3, it emits 6328, which is in the visible region, or we can say the wavelength or the color of this beam is towards red. Then we have a third transition, E4 to E3. It emits, E4 to E3 transition will emit 1.15 micrometer, which is in the IR region. Again, E3 to E2, there is a spontaneous emission. E2 to E1, there is a de-excitation of the particles. In case of helium neon laser, the question is why this is called as four-level laser system? As active medium is neon atom, and in neon atom, we have a 6 energy level. So, the answer for this is the entire laser process takes place in the four parts. That's why it is called as four-level laser system. Mean first part is the absorption. The particle will absorb energy from electrons and it will excite into the excited state, that is a metastable state for the helium. So this is the first transition from ground state to higher energy level of the helium. Then this helium atom will collide with the neon and transfer its energy to neon. So neon will take the second laser action, that is E6 to E3. That is second step. Then there is a transition E3 to E2, third state, and E2 to E1 is a fourth state. That's why this is called as four-level laser system. If we are considering any one of the laser action, suppose we are considering other laser action, for example, 1.15 micrometer. So the first level is absorption of energy from helium, and helium will excite into the metastable state. So this is the first transition. So we'll say this is the first level. Then this energy transfer to the neon. So this neon atom will come into the E4 energy level, that is a metastable state. Then we have a next second transition, that is E4 to E3, giving us a laser beam in the IR region. Then we have third transition is a spontaneous emission, and fourth transition is from E2 to E1. Means if we consider any laser action out of these three, it will take in four different levels. First one is the absorption, second one is the stimulated emission, third one spontaneous emission, and fourth one is the de-excitation of particle. That's why this helium neon laser system is called as four-level laser system. Let us see what are the merits, demerits and application of the helium neon laser. First merit is, it is operated continuously, means it is giving us a continuous laser beam. Then the output of this laser is highly monochromatic. This laser beam is highly stable and there is no separate cooling arrangement required for the entire setup. So these are the merits of the helium neon laser. Demerit is, the output power for the helium neon laser is very less. The output power is in some milliwatts. So this is the disadvantage or demerit for the helium neon laser. Then application is in the hologram. Hologram is a technique which is giving us a 3D image of the 3D object. Then the next application is communication. So in optical communication system, the role of laser is a very important, and there we are using helium neon laser. So this is about the helium neon laser. Thanks for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekeeda and please subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.